The sub-bituminous coal from the Drumheller mining district was mainly used for home heating, cooking, and electrical generation. It was also used to power the steam locomotives of the Canadian National and Canadian Pacific Railways on the prairies. The flat-lying seams were easier to mine than those found in more mountainous areas. With lower levels of methane gas, the coal mining era lasted from 1911 to 1984, when the Atlas number 3 and 4 mines closed. The Atlas number 3 mine structures are preserved and form the basis of the National Historic Site, administered by the Atlas Mine Historical Society. The mine features the last wooden coal tipple in Canada. Built in 1937, the tipple is a coal loading and sorting machine. At over 7 stories tall, the tipple now serves as a reminder of the rich mining history of the Drumheller Valley. Old mining equipment, including a working pre-1936 battery-powered locomotive, and several buildings including the wash house, supply house, lamp house, and mine office still stand at the site. The site preserves the stories and artifacts of the man who once mined the black. The Atlas is the last of 139 mines that once ruled the valley. 13 people died during the mine's operation. 4 died on one day, June 24, 1941, when a gas explosion killed 3 and a 4th gave his life in a vain attempt to rescue them.
That's pretty cool. This used to be their helmet with the headlight. Oh, there are actually names on it. Let's see it. And that is Thomas Bellet. Safety lamps. This place here. Oh, they have all this stuff. So that's the lamp house, the mystery of lamp house. Can I get in there? It's the wash house. That looks scary though. It's a bit creepy here. It's kind of cold, this is sir. Wow. Oh, look at this. Dresses being hanged. It's a little cold in here. These clothes being hanged looks creepy. So this is a bathhouse. Safety has no quitting time. All right, this is the bathhouse. Bye bye. I think there are people up there. Yeah. Miners paid monthly for the use of the wash house, while the coal miners showered daily. His family used the wash house only on Sundays. This guy right here. This is an interesting part. In the 1930s and 40s, most residents managed a weekly bath by heating water on their coal stoves because they showered every day. Miners were the cleanest men in town. There you go. The cleanest man in town, huh? I'm going back down. smells ancient.
Good lighting, eh?
What is this place? Thank you.
ghosts of the past still active these days.